Okay, so this is another video for another friend of mine who's asking me witchy questions. So I'm going to answer the witchy questions to the best of my knowledge. Now, this particular witchy person is a novice witch and just barely beginning into her powers and all that other stuff. And she's trying to make sense of it all. And the very first thing that I can recommend is that it doesn't make sense. So let's start with her first question, which is, am I sleeping a lot? Because I'm a thinking that somebody's trying to contact me in the dream realm. Yes, no, kind of, sort of, maybe. Now, it depends on whether or not you remember your dreams. Like, I will give you an example. In my life, when I'm very, very stressed, I will have dreams, and they always happen in my childhood home. And I'm always trying to resolve something catastrophic, like, there was nuclear holocaust and everything's burned out, like in Dreamscape, and I'm trying to make sure that my parents have water, or I can't find a room in my house that's always there, or I see my childhood dog Bandit, and she's trying to get me to find something. And it's usually, so I've recognized that this is my dream pattern, that when I'm stressed, when I'm not sleeping properly, when I'm all messed up, I will have these perpetual dreams. So it's not so much your subconscious trying to contact you or something from the other realm trying to contact you. It is your innermost thoughts trying to contact you. As to sleeping a lot, you probably just need to sleep. You are a very, very up person. And so I'm thinking that the sleeping is your body's way of trying to counteract all of your awake activities. And you do have a lot in your mind. So, slowing down, meditating, learning to breathe, and also learning the past, you can't do anything about it. The future isn't here. So all you can worry about is the now. And living in the now is a very, very challenging thing, especially when, we've been trained to be aware of what could happen, and so we set ourselves up to what could happen. So I'm looking at, your question, and basically what I'm just saying is just, see it for what it is. If it makes you feel better, journal what you've seen in your dreams and look for a pattern. As to whether or not it's the ether trying to contact you, trust me, if the ether wants to contact you, the ether will contact you. And what I mean by the ether is those entities that appear to us. And when we start having the entities start appearing to us, one of the big challenges that we have with the entities appearing and speaking to us is differentiating between, is this my soul? Is this my true self? Or is it truly a message? And the one very, very important thing that we've always say throughout the whole realm is that just because they're dead doesn't mean they're smarter than you, okay? So remember, your true self is that little voice in your head that answers, is this true? Is this right? Because we have so much telling us constantly, you're not right, you're not right, you're not right. If you do this, this will happen to you. We have all this marketing constantly hitting at us. And we have to remember to ourselves and be true to our true inner voice that says, is this right? Is this the best thing for me? And that is your true soul. So listen for that voice, that little voice that's inside, that's deep inside, that's telling you that this is true and this is right. Now, seeing things from your peripheral vision, just like the shadow world, okay? There's shadow people, there's shadow things, there's shadow entities, there's all kinds of things in the realms and in the shadows. And you have a couple of choices. You can either be like, it's the shadows, or you can just be like, that's the shadows. And I've chosen that because being super, super sensitive, it used to be I couldn't go through a graveyard without having a physical reaction. I couldn't be anywhere near the Alamo without having a physical reaction. Anytime there's any kind of an iffy, I start having a physical reaction and I'm like, what? And then all of a sudden, like, oh, there's a graveyard. Oh, there's one of those reliquary things on the side of the road where somebody is paying homage to somebody who was killed in a car accident or whatever, you know? There's all kinds of periphery. And so I've learned to just go, okay, it's the periphery. So, and it's a skill that you learn. And then you start learning if it's something that you need to pay attention to. The other thing that I've learned is I have high functioning anxiety. And I've learned that when my brain starts going, and you know, when I start getting triggered and I start going, I've learned to go, I've actually named my anxiety Fritz. And I go, Fritz, we'll talk about this later. And that's my inner voice. That's my inside Penny. That's my true soul self going, you're better than your anxiety. You're better than the iffies. You're better than the peripheries. You're better than the training. You are more intelligent than all of the crap that you've got piled onto your plate. Xenobomb, you are amazing and incredible, and you've been given this gift, and you've been given this amazing path, and you are doing shit that I would love to do, which is actually research and focus in on all of these things that you're learning. And there's this area in our path where we're protected by our naivete. And then as we dig and we learn our skills and we become more and more and more and more enlightened, and we start, and the universe starts sending us these amazing people to open us up even more, then we start losing that innocence. And we start learning that there's more and more and more to the rabbit hole. And so what you have to do is learn that fine line between, is this going to impact me or can I let it go? And just put it in the back burner for future reference. And I'm going to give you a little story about this lady that I met named Miss Rita. And the first time I met her, now remember, when you're doing this whole thing, you're going to meet some of the most amazing, incredible, enlightened, great, off the chart, incredible people, like, you know, like Abraham Hicks. You know, or you're going to meet some people that you're just like, step away slowly. And when I first met Miss Rita, I truly felt, step away, because this was her steal. So she said that she does not like to sleep on mattresses with coils. And the reason for that is because the coils amplify the messages from them. And I'm like, okay, who's them? What are the messages? But whatever. And then she said, you know, and back when we had lead paint in the houses, then the messages couldn't get through because the lead paint blocked it. And so she can't have a nice sleep on a coil mattress because lead paint has now been banned. So the messages from them can get through all the time. So she doesn't sleep on a coil mattress at all. Pick your poison. So I thought that this was the most Looney Tune thing I'd ever heard in my whole life. And I'm like, whoa, no, no. And then, so I filed that in my back pocket. Then I start hearing about the tone. And there's like this whole thing about, you know, like this, you know, God trumpet calling tone thing that happens like in the north and stuff. And then I started hearing about, you know, some other them things. And part of me was kind of like, maybe Miss Rita wasn't so crazy. But maybe Miss Rita is crazy. But I don't know, am I crazy for believing Miss Rita? Or am I just filing that for future reference? You just don't know. So that's what I'm telling you, is that when you're doing this path, you're going to collect data. You're going to collect things that you just file in your little witchy file cabinet. And you're going to pull them up when you see it fit. When you have a girlfriend that comes to you and says, oh my God, this terrible thing is happening. And you're like, I got a spell for that. Or you've got somebody coming to you and going, blah, 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 blah. And you go, I remember I read that in blah, blah, blah. So I think I'm going to pull up the information and blah, blah, blah. So you see what I'm saying? So one, file it. If it resonates with you, then it's a message that's being sent to you. It's either being sent to you by the universe. The universe is going, I'm giving you this information, and it's going to help you along your path. And you take that information and you go along your path. Okay? Or it's just like, well, this is some weird shit. And you just file it in your back burner. And then eventually, if that crazy shit that stuck, even though it was crazy, starts to make sense to you, then it was a message. So that's how it all works. And so when it comes to periphery people, just go, eh. You know, when it comes to your anxiety, give it a name and say, yeah, hey, we'll talk about that later. And then you're done. And that's how you do it. And you deal with it day by day. And if it's sleepy and you're getting the same dream over and over again, I know now in my sleep patterns that if I dream about my childhood home, then I'm under a lot of stress. So, was my childhood home stressful? Yeah, kind of, sort of. But anyways, so that's what the universe wants you to know. And I hope I answered your questions. And I look forward to seeing you the next time I see you. Alrighty? So, I'll talk to you later. Bye.